Hi, hello, vanakkam, namaste, adab. Welcome to Travel Nestam. If you like my video, please share and subscribe. The distance between Bangalore to Chikmagalur is around 250 kilometers. You can easily reach there either bus or train. Note, only one train is available. After you reach Chikmagalur, in order to see the places around, you have to hire a vehicle, either a cab or a bike. Hiring a cab would be fine if you are a group of people, but not when you are traveling solo. The other option is join a group of travelers if you don't mind meeting new people. I joined BCF and I am traveling with the other city freaks. Our first stop is Yagachi Water Sports. There are lots of people waiting in queue for their turn. I have already experienced this kind of ride, so I am not that interested. You can even avail the whole ride in packages. For weekdays it's 1000 and for weekends it's 1200. You know, the first coffee crop was grown in Babu Budangiri Range, Chikmagalur in India. So don't miss the taste of coffee there. The Buttermilk alias Dabda, or you can say Jari Waterfalls, is located on the steep and rugged road down through the private coffee plantations. Visitors are not allowed to take their own vehicle on this way. One must take a jeep ride down the hill, which would cost 100 per person. The condition of the road is very bad. I feel I am in a roller coaster. We have reached the waterfalls. There is a small canteen for refreshments. Wow, the view is amazing, but there is little bit of crowd too. The water is so cold that I feel like I'm walking in ice. There are many homestays on the hills. You can choose one of your own budget. At the night, the temperature falls between 12 to 15 degrees. Ta-da! Campfire! The place is very calm. The night view of stars and the moon on the sky is mesmerizing. My night passed away with the travel stories from my fellow travelers. The best part I liked is there is no mobile signals over there, so no disturbance. Enjoy the night peacefully to the fullest. Next, we started the trek to Mullayanagiri, the highest peak in Karnataka. It is the place where we started the trek. It's called Sarpadari. Sarpa means snake. It is 3 to 4 km trek from here, which took us almost 4 hours. The trek is moderate. There are no other people except my group on the way to the peak. These days, all the tourist places are crowded with people. I really love getting lost in the woods and being close to nature. Journey is important than destination, because that is the time where you enjoy more and get to know each other more. Finally reached the peak point. It's over 6,300.17 feet high from sea level. There is a roadway to reach this peak. You just have to walk 450 to 500 steps. Heading back to have some food, I really like the belpuri in small shops near the parking area. Since there is no parking available for buses and tempos, we are walking for further another 10 to 15 minutes to reach the tempo parking. This is the place for tempo and buses parking. From here, you can avail jeep services to the peak or trek the little mountain that I have shown you before. The last and final stop is Belur Chenakesava Temple. The ceiling of the temple was amazing. It was said it can be rotated along its center, not now, but quite a many days long. This Hoyasala architecture is commissioned by King Vishnuvardhana and took 3 generations, almost 103 years to get completed. You will find many miniature shrines around the temple. The miniatures themselves are so intricately carved that they do not look as modern, but actually mini temples. I was wondered how our ancient people could have made such a nice and clear carvings with so much detail in every sculpture. With lots of memories, heading back to normal schedule. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.